In this video lecture, we are going to discuss our next topic after normalization, that is called as stemming. So first, we have to understand what is stemming. So before going into the stemming part, first let us understand what is suffix stripping. So suffix stripping is simply an operation by which suffixes are removed from the terms. These terms are we got after normalizing a token. So when we remove suffixes from them, we call it as suffix stripping. Okay. As we know, a document is represented by a vector of words or terms. So following is an example containing terms with the common stem. So what is a stem? Stem is nothing but a root by which a word is created. Okay. So let us consider these terms, that is connect, connected, connecting, connection and connections. So if we strip the suffixes from it. So we have to strip ed from here, ing from here, ion from here, ions from here. Then all these words will convert into a common stem, that is a connect. So we call that stem as a root word. Okay. So that stemming is a process of converting the terms into their stem or a root. Okay. So what is stemming? So according to the definition, so in linguistic morphology and information retrieval, stemming is the process of reducing terms to their roots before indexing, so that indexing is can be performed. Okay. And stemming programs are commonly referred to as stemming algorithms and sometimes called or also called as stemmers. Okay. So stemming suggest crude affix chopping, that is language dependent. Like we take an example, we have terms automates, automatic and automation. If we generate or convert or reduce them to their stem, then the stem will be automat. Okay, so this is the actual word from which these words are generated. So this process, the converting the terms to their stem, is called as stemming. Okay. So for stemming purpose, there is a very popular algorithm which is called as Porter Stammer. So in this section of this lecture, we are going to discuss this Porter Stammer in detail. Okay. So this is one of the common algorithm for stemming English language words. This algorithm consists of 5 sets of rules that are applied in order, that is one by one. So these phases are applied sequentially. And each phase in this algorithm consists of a set of commands that are to be executed. Okay. And the sample convention says, of the rules in a compound command, select the one that applies to the longest suffix. So we'll take an example and we'll understand these steps one by one. Okay. So before starting the algorithmic part, first we have to understand the conventions of it and the definition part. So the Porter Stammer defines two terms, that is a consonant and a vowel. So what is a consonant? As we know in English language, the letters that are other than A, E, I, O, U, and a letter Y which is preceded by consonant are considered to be as consonant, and a vowel any other letter that is not a consonant. So in a vowel is that is A, E, I, O and U. Okay. So these are consonants and vowels. So with this definition, all words in the Porter Stammer are of the form like this, that is bracket C, bracket VC, that is with the power M and then V. So C here denotes the string of one or more consonants. V denotes the string of one or more vowels, and VC denotes the combination of vowels and consonants, and the C and V which are appearing in brackets represents the arbitrary value of consonant and vowel. Okay. And M denotes, this M is the very important term here, so M denotes the measure of word or a word part which is represented in this form, that is VC. Okay. So let us first understand how do we calculate measure value or measure the M value for a particular word. Okay. So Consider an example like we have this word, that is tree or by or tr. Okay. So m is calculated by, as we have discussed, that when represented in this form. So if our word is containing this type of sequence, vowel and then consonant, then we count them and then we measure it. So if we see this word, that is tree. So this word does not contain any combination of vowel and then consonant. Okay. So we can see this is a consonant, this is a consonant, this is a vowel, this is a vowel. So we have a combination of consonant and vowel, but there is no combination of first vowel and then consonant. So for this, M value will be 0. The measurement will be 0. And similar is the case with BY and TR. Now consider another example for which M equal to 1. So we have this word trouble. As you can see, it is containing a consonant, then vowel, followed by a vowel, and this vowel is followed by a consonant. So we have this combination that which is appearing as VC, that is a vowel and then consonant. Similar is the case with this. Suppose in this we have, this is vowel and then this is consonant. So AT is the vowel consonant combination. In this, ES is the vowel consonant combination, and so on. So for this value, we have only one combination that are appearing in these words. So for them, M value will be 1. Now let us take another example. We have a word troubles. So in this, as we have seen, that U is a vowel and then B is a consonant. So we have one combination here, and after that ES. So E is a vowel, S is a consonant. So it is another combination which is appearing there. Similarly, the word private. So we have I as a vowel and V as a consonant, then A as a vowel and T is the consonant. So we have two combinations here also, and so on. So for these type of words, the measurement or the M value will be 2. Okay. Now on the basis of this M value, the Porter stammer works as follows. So for stemming using the Porter stammer, there are certain rules that we have to follow. The rules which are written are generally of the form, that is bracket condition, S1 maps to S2, where S1 and S2 are suffixes. So what does it mean? What does this denote? This means that if a word ends with the suffix S1, so if we have any word that is ending with the suffix S1 and the stem before S1, so S1 is the part last with a, so the stem before S1, the word which is we are taking as a stem or root before the S1 satisfies this given condition, then S1 will be replaced by S2. Okay. So let us understand it with an example. Suppose we have this example that says, if rule is M bracket, M greater than 1, EMENT arrows null. So in this we can see that suffix S1 is EMENT and suffix S2 is null, that is nothing. So if we follow, apply this rule on this word, that is replacement. So first we have to check the measurement M value for this. So we can see we have M greater than 1 as, which is a VC combination, vowel consonant. Then AC is the vowel consonant. Then EM is the vowel consonant combination. And EN is also a vowel consonant. So we have M value, which is 4. So it is greater than 1. So we can apply this rule over this word. Okay. So when we apply this rule on this word, then this replacement, the EMENT part will be replaced by S2, that is null. So this word will map to replace, that is REPLAC. Okay. So this is how Porter stammer works. So all the conditions all the rules that Porter stammer applies will be of the form like this, that is condition and suffix S1 maps to suffix S2. Then the condition part may also contain the following, that is, we have discussed the M, that is the measure of the stem. Then star S denotes the stems that ends with S. Okay. Third condition may be of type this, star V star means the stem that contains a vowel. Okay, the stem of the word that is containing a vowel. Then fourth condition may be written as star D means the stem ends with a double consonant, that is TT or SS. So any stem that ends with a double consonant will be represented by this. And then star O. This denotes the stem ends in CVC, that is in the combination of consonant, then vowel, then consonant. And the condition is the second C. This is the second C. This second C should not be W, X or Y. Okay. So for example, like this, will. So it is containing consonant, then vowel, then consonant. And this last consonant is not W, X or Y. And same is the case with hop. Okay, so the condition part may also contain expressions with and, or, and not expressions. So a typical condition may be written as this. That says am greater than 1 and bracket star S or star T that tests for a stem. So it means it is testing for a stem with am greater than 1 and the stem which is ending in S or T with the alphabet S or T. Okay, so the condition may be the complex condition may appear in this format also. Okay, so the Potter stemmer, as we have discussed, works in the five steps. So first step, part A, it suggests if we have a word or we have a term that is ending with SSES, we'll simply chop it and replace it by double S. So for example, we have a KRSS, then after applying Potter stemmer, it will appear as KRS. Okay. So if any token, if any term is ending with IES, it will be replaced by I. So if we have a word ponies, it will be replaced by, in this IES will be replaced by simply I. So it will become pony. If we have ties, then it will become tie. If we have double S, then it will remain same. So KRS will remain KRS. And if it is ending with simple S, 1S, then it will be replaced by null value. So this sign is representing null. So for example, if we have cats, then it will be replaced by cat. The stem will be cat. So S will be removed from here. So this is step number 1A. That is very basic part. Okay. Then step B, 1B. It suggests the stemming with conditions. Like say, the first condition says M greater than 1 EED. Okay. So the condition, according to condition, it says if the measurement of the stem is greater than 1, that is the combination of vowel and consonant is appearing greater than 1 and it is ending with EED. So EED is nothing but a suffix S1, then it will be replaced by simple EE. So for this, if we say agreed. Okay. So in this, E double ED is nothing but a S1. So the remaining stem is AGR. So we can see in AGR, we have one vowel and then consonant. Okay. And in ED, we have vowel and then consonant. So this condition is verified with this condition. So this will be simply converted into agree. So double ED will be replaced by double E. Similar is the case with FEED, that is feed. So in this case, we can see condition is not verified as we have only one VC combination, which is not greater than 1. So it will remain the same. Okay. Now next condition says star V star ED will be replaced by null. Means if our stem is containing a vowel, okay, followed by ED, then it will be replaced by null. So we have a term that is plastered. So we can see if we apply an stem, so if we take ED, so we can see it is containing vowels A and E. So it is containing vowels. So it will be replaced by, the ED will be replaced by null. So it will become plaster. Then we have another condition, another word, that is bled. So if we take out this part from here, so the remaining stem is containing only two word, two alphabets, that is BL, and nothing, none of them is vowel. So it will remain blood. So because condition is not verified here. Third condition says, if we have similar the case with ED and double ED, that is, if we chop out this ing part, then remaining stem is containing vowel. So it is containing vowel here, so it will be replaced by null value. That ing will be replaced by s2, that is null. And in this case, if we take out ing from it, then remaining letter is s, which is not a vowel. So this rule will not be applied here. So it will become sync. Okay. This is step number B. So once a word is passed through step number 1B, it will go into step number 1C, or which is called as sometimes called as cleanup part. It's going to go into cleanup. So these rules are ran if second or third rule in the 1B apply. These rules are only applied when certain word, for certain word, the rules that are appearing in second or third or part of 1B are also applied. So consider situation, if the word is coming as AT, it will be replaced by ATE. So suppose after applying the stemming in the last rule, using the last rules like this, that is plastered, motoring, agreed, and so on. So if we found a word like conflict, okay, that is ending with AT. So what we do, we simply convert it into ATE, because this word is stem, is a stem of the word conflated. So if we remove ED from it, what we are getting after removing ED, that is phi, that or sorry, epsilon, that is null. So it is remaining part is conflict. So convert it to proper word, that is conflict, so that it can be searched easily. If we are having a stem that is ending with BL, that is TROUBL. So as you know, in English, there is no word that is like this trouble. So what we do, we simply clean up with this and apply, convert into BLE, that is trouble. Okay. Third condition says, that is star D and not L or S or Z. That is, star D means that is the stem that ends with double consonant. Okay. That ends with double consonant. You can refer to the slide number 3 of this lecture that we are studying. So if the stem ends with double consonant and that consonant is not L or S or Z, then we convert it into a single letter. So this, suppose we have this hop, H-O-P-P. After stemming hopping, it the stem is remaining as hop. And we can see that it is ending with the two consonants, double consonant, that is P-P. And this is not, the consonants are not L, S or Z. So we simply convert it into a single letter, that is hop. Similar is the case with tanned, which is converted into tan. But if we see the case of falling, so after stemming, the word remains as fall. So we can see it is ending with two consonant, but that consonant is L. So it will not be converted into a single letter. Okay. Next condition says, if we have M equal to 1, that measure of the stem is 1, and stem ends, the O denotes stem ends in CVC, that is consonant, vowel, consonant case, where second consonant is not W, X or Y, then we'll simply map it to E. So we have filing, word filing, which after stemming reduced to file. So it is having the M value 1 because it is having the combination of vowel and then consonant. Okay. And if we apply O condition, that the stem is ending with CVC, that is consonant, vowel and consonant, and this is that second consonant is not W, X or Y, so we simply apply E with that. Okay. And in this case, condition is not verified because it is ending with CVC, it is not ending with CVC. You can see here that it is ending with vowel and then consonant. So the condition is not validated here. So it will remain same. That is fail. Then step number 1C, that is the Y elimination. So it says that if the stem of the word contains a vowel and then Y, then it will be stemmed to, converted into I. So suppose we have this happy. So if we take out Y from it, then the remaining stem is containing A, one vowel. So it will be converted to HAPPI. So Y will be replaced by I. But if we see here sky, if we chop out sky Y from here, then the remaining symbols are, that is S and K, which are not, which is not containing vowels. So the rule will not be applied here. The condition is not verified here. Okay. Step number two of the Potter's stammer, which is called as derivational morphology one. That is, if M is greater than zero and it, the stem and the word is ending with ational, then it will be converted to 8. Similar is the case that if the word is containing isation, then it will be converted to IZE. And similar is the case with if the word is containing sensibility, that is ability word, then it will be converted to BLE. So that sensibility will be converted into sensible. Steps 3 and 4 that are called as derivational morphology 2 and derivational morphology 3, that contains these following rules. Okay, that is similar as we have discussed in the previous rules. So we have to just check that the M conditions and the words ending with ikate, full and ness, and similarly ANCE, ENT and IVE, and accordingly whatever the rule is saying, we have to convert that word into its stem. Okay. And the last step of the Potter stammer is step 5, that is called as cleanup part, which is again containing certain conditions. That is, if M is greater than 1, that is measure is, if for a word the measure is greater than 1 and it is ending with E, so it will be mapped into a null part. That is, suppose if we take probate, it is ending with E and the remaining stem is containing combinations of VC, that is OB and AT, which is greater than 1. So it will be simply converted into bait. And similarly, if M is greater than 1, sorry, M is equal to 1 and it is not O, that is, and the stem is not ending in CVC and containing any double S at the end, so it will be mapped into a null. So goodness will be converted into good. Similar and next last step, step 5b says, if M is greater than 1 and the stem ends with double consonant and the stem ends with L, then it will be converted into a single letter. That is, if we have control, that is ending with double L, it will be converted into control. Okay, because M is greater than 1 here, because we see we have a combination of O and VC and we have combination of OL, that is VC, so it is greater than 1. But in the case of roll, we have only one combination, that is VC, so which is not greater than 1, so condition will not be verified here. So this is control and this is roll. Okay, so this is how our stemming process works, and this is how our Potter stammer applies the stemming onto the tokens which we have got after normalizing the tokens. So first we have a word, from the word we fetch tokens. From tokens, we convert or normalize them into terms, and then we apply the stemming process on these terms so that we can get the roots, okay, or stems. So this is how stemming works in detail. Okay, so in the next lecture, we are going to cover our next topic, which is called as lemmatization. So that is all for now. If you like our videos, then kindly subscribe our channel, and if you have any query, then you may ask in our comment section. Thank you so much.